Hey folks, it's me again, Al McCray with TampaNewsAndTalk.com. We are Tampa's last place news. Yeah, you might as well be honest, we're not number one or two. We're Tampa's last place news. We've been around 8 years now and we have a variety of shows. You name it, we all crossed the map. Today I have a very unusual candidate. Very unusual candidate. African-American female running for governor of the state of Florida. And with a brand new party on top of that. Her name is F.D. Moore. Ms. Moore, thanks for driving from Orlando in this cold, breezy weather to be on the show.
Thank you, Mr. McCray, for having me. I appreciate it.
You're the first black female candidate that I've ever met is running for governor.
Thank you.
How long have you been running for governor? How long?
Well, this has been in the works for several years, but I knew after I tried to organize and infiltrate with the Republican Party. Of course, I'm not a Democrat. I'm a conservative, pretty much very conservative. And I decided to start a new party to bring God back into the government.
A new party.
A new party.
New candidate and new party.
New party. Yes. New Centurions Party. And it's based on the foundation of the Bible and the Constitution. Those will be the only two things that will guide us in this party. And if it's not in the Bible or the Constitution, as governing party, I will not do it.
Where did that name come from, New Centurion?
New Centurions is the Roman centurion in the Bible that helped Jesus to carry the cross.
Now, when did this party get started?
This party originally started 2010.
Are you the founder of this party?
Yes, I am.
How many members in this party so far?
Right now, we're doing our first membership drive because we had to file and do all the things over the years. So we're starting our first membership drive. We have very few members, but we expect to increase and expand that very rapidly.
You know, running for governor is a very tall order. It takes tremendous amount of resources, both manpower and financial. You need about what? $100 million to become governor in the state of Florida? $100 million?
Not really. Look at President Trump. They said he ran against a machine that had over close to $2 billion, and he didn't need near that much, and he won. So I don't expect to spend $100 million.
How much money do you figure?
I think I can win maybe with $50
million. $50 million?
Yes. I believe I can do that.
Have you started fundraising yet?
Yes, I have. And you can go to the website.
How's that going?
It's beginning to generate.
Okay. And how have you been getting the word out?
Emailing different organizations, on the phone, networking with organizations and people. And I am by trade a commercial real estate broker.
Okay.
So I'm out there in the public and I'm always meeting people. And I have the gift to talk.
So, just an independent party, so there won't be no primary.
There will not be a primary. I've already picked my lieutenant governor, Tim Economou.
Okay.
And we're ready, and we have volunteers that are ready to get started and running. I have volunteers from my Holy Family Catholic Church in Orlando.
Mm-hmm.
I have volunteers from other friends that have organizations, and they're ready to help. They're ready for a new party. They're ready to put God back in the school, into the government. And they, like me, feel that we wouldn't have all of these problems, mass shootings, our kids not learning, the government having all this corruption in it. Look at Washington, what they've been doing and what they did to the candidate, President Trump. how they tried to keep him from winning. So we need God, and we need to go back to the basis of our Constitution.
Okay, I have some particular issues to ask you, and if I get some brief responses, what about felon getting their rights back to vote? How do you feel about that?
I believe everyone deserves a second chance and should have the opportunity to remigrate into life and have the ability to get a job and to vote and to participate in our government as a part of society.
How soon do felons get the right to vote reinstated if you become governor? How soon?
I would say within 3 to 5 years.
That long?
It depends if they're on probation.
Okay.
You know, that's, or if they're on parole, that's gonna, once they're off parole and they've completed and they've showed that they can follow the guidelines of our state and participate, the minute they're off, if they're on a 2-year parole or 3-year, then within a year they should have their voting rights.
So you're saying they have to finish all their time on, it's called time on paper?
Yes.
Okay, and what about the rights of people that are falsely accused of things? Would that be a fund to defend people who are falsely accused?
Absolutely. I was falsely accused here in Tampa, and I had to, I know it was a blessing in disguise, because I got to learn the judicial system and what was wrong with it. Before that, I always thought if I saw someone in a chain gang going into the courthouse, that they had done something wrong.
And were guilty.
But once God put me in that situation, I had a dream 3 nights before, you're going to jail. And I was on my way to school working on my master's and went to jail.
How long were you in jail?
24 hours.
But it was enough for you to learn the system.
It was enough for me to learn the system. And the system is a machine of making money. Why not let these people free and let them go out and earn a living, and then you get the taxes from them? Don't falsely accuse someone so you can get $25 a head or $50 a head for every prisoner that's in jail or in the prison.
What about the infrastructure of the state? What do you plan on doing with the roads and mass transit?
I was sorely disappointed when I moved here from Houston, Texas, because we have loops and toll roads that are 8 lanes, and I want to improve it and expand it to handle the traffic here in Florida.
Well, Orlando, where you are right now, seems to be getting all the money in the state. So Orlando, I guess because of the tourist business, I guess.
Because of the tourist business, but I also think Tampa and Tallahassee, and as we're growing as an economic state, Governor Scott bringing all the jobs in, and I want to continue to do that. I know Governor Scott personally. I know he's got a lot of friends out there. I appreciate what he's done, but I would like to take it even further.
Okay, and what are you going to do about the school situation with dropouts and
the school system?
Improve the graduation rate of high school students.
The school system is it's a big problem. The voucher system, I think that would help. I also believe, I'm a strong advocate, that these churches can start schools.
Church schools.
Get God back into these schools.
But where would the money come from to fund church schools? It would come from out of the public school system?
It would come from the public school system. If they're flunking and they're failing these students and they can't bring the level of education up, then we take their funding from them and we give it to the churches.
Really? So would be faith-based education then?
Faith-based education. And for those parents that don't want their kids to go to a faith-based, they can continue in the public schools.
And where would the money come from to replace the money that's taken out of the school system for vouchers?
Well, it's per student. Mm-hmm. So if they have less students, then they would need less money.
Okay, very good point. Now, what about the situation where you have a lot of these schools are failing, voucher schools are failing? How have you stopped that?
Well, we would go in there and have our local Department of Education or State Department of Education do a forensic examination, find out why it's failing, and what we can do to bring the voucher school systems up to the level that they need to be. If it can't be fixed, then we'll have to look into other alternative situations like Texas did. Their schools were far, far behind several years ago, and now they're up to A schools and B schools, great passing levels. And so we can look at the plans of other states and get ideas and bring people in to see if we can turn the school system around.
Okay. How long have you lived in Florida?
I've been in Florida since 2006.
So you had a chance to crisscross the state and...
Yes, I've been Tallahassee. I've been to the... I helped Governor Scott in his campaign. I've crisscrossed the state, and I've grown to love Florida, and I want what's best for the people of Florida, and I want us to grow and bloom and blossom, and I want us to unite, and I want us to have a colorblind state. This is not about color. All people are mankind, and we are God's people, so we need to think that way and stop this separation. And that's another reason I want this party, because we're all God's people. God in the Constitution, leave color out of it.
Now, the last hurricane almost decimated the citrus industry in the state. What do you say to the farmers to help them recover?
Well, we would do with the farmers like they're doing with the people that have come here from Puerto Rico. They help those people from Puerto Rico. So we would help the farmers and give them more money to rebound, because that is an integral part of Florida.
Definitely.
Our farmers with the fruit trees and the strawberries and vegetables, and we need them. It's a intricate part of the employment and work community.
Okay. Have you had any experience with this sort of thing in the past, or with the industry?
I lived on a farm, as a matter of fact, in Texas. So I know, I've driven tractors.
A female tractor driver.
Female tractor driver. I've helped bale hay. We grew gardens. We grew sugarcane sorghums. We would go to the country when I was a teenager. My grandmother and grandfather were missionaries, and we had a country house and we lived in the city. And so I've milked cows. I know it all. I've done it all. It's like God planned this life for me, and I'm ready.
When it comes to parents disciplining their kids, how do you feel about parents beating their kids?
I don't believe in beating, but I do believe in spanking.
Okay, and what about the juvenile detention problem here?
Juvenile detention. Well, the juveniles, that's a problem, and we need sources of outtakes of places they can go, counseling. We need to give them support, because a lot of juveniles don't have support. They don't have families, like the Boys and Girls Club. Mm-hmm. I go there and I volunteer. There's a lot of places where we can help juveniles that have problems.
What is the answer to mass transit?
Mass transit?
Besides more money.
Well, we're doing good with the rail system. We need to improve our bus system. And we'll have to take a look at what some of the other states are doing.
Higher taxes to cover mass transit, or what?
I'm not for higher taxes, but I wouldn't ever say never.
Okay. Have you been recently in South Florida recently?
I'm sorry?
Have you been to South Florida recently? Fort Lauderdale, Miami recently?
I have not been there. It's been about a year and a half since I've been there.
Because they had a mass influx of people from Puerto Rico.
Yes, and we have that in Orlando also. Okay. We have loads of Puerto Ricans.
What should a state do to help people from Puerto Rico?
Well, they should help them temporarily, and hopefully with the billions of dollars that the Washington is going to send them to help them rebuild Puerto Rico, they can resubmit themselves into Puerto Rico and their community.
How long is temporary help?
Temporary help, I don't think should be over 5 years.
Well, that's more than usual.
Five years is max. They were speaking, we have these people from El Salvador, they've been here 17 years, that's way too long.
Okay.
I think 5 years is max.
What about the healthcare, Medicaid expansion, how do you feel about that?
I think there are other solutions that we can work on.
Such as?
There are programs where there's a program where I think it's through AMAC where you can join a group and it's a minimal amount because everyone is sharing in the burden of maybe someone else's health care being higher.
Correct.
So we would look into those types of insurance programs to help people.
Okay, we have no problem with expanding Medicaid though. Any problem with that? Because Republicans are known for not wanting to expand Medicare, mainly because it's an Obama issue.
Well, I would look at all sides of the coin.
But for the Obamacare, how do you feel about Obamacare?
I was not for Obamacare.
But most Republicans were not. You were a Republican before, weren't you?
Yes.
I can tell.
Yes. I was not for Obamacare.
How about now?
Well, what happened to me personally was my insurance left Florida because of Obamacare.
Too expensive?
It was too expensive. They had too many people on. It was draining them. I was on a health care, and they last year they left, and I had to find another health care.
And how did you find your health care? Was it through Obama plan or just independent plan?
Independent.
And what were the rates you were paying? Was it a reasonable rate?
The rates are reasonable.
Lower than what you were paying before?
A little higher. Higher.
Would Obamacare be cheaper or higher?
Obamacare was cheaper, but it's draining the system, and the health providers are not able to maintain because the younger people that they thought would sign up are not signing up for health care to help carry the burden of older generations on the health care plan.
Well, because of the health care mandate, they're not being penalized anymore, so there's no incentive for them to join. So that's probably what on the pool.
Right.
What about these alternative taxicab companies like Lyft and Uber? How do you feel about those companies?
I'm good with those. I was in Washington, D.C. at a class, and I caught an Uber because I thought I need to experience this. I caught one. It was fine. It was perfect. I think they need to be vetted more, and we need to check their background and make sure that they're legal here and they're not, you know, felons and they haven't committed any rapes or crimes like that. But I think it's totally fair.
So you'd be all in favor of expanding?
Expanding. Okay. Uber and Lyft, yes.
And what about taxes on rental cars? Is it a special tax on rental cars? How do you feel about eliminating that or expanding those taxes?
Well, I think that helps bring money into the state because we have lots of visitors from other countries that rent rental cars and they don't pay any taxes. Mm-hmm. So I think that's the way for us to bring taxes. I wouldn't say take it any higher. I've used rental cars. If I drive to Tallahassee or if I drive to Miami, I don't drive my vehicle. I use a rental car because I don't like to get a lot of miles on my vehicle. Okay. So I paid the tax. I think it's fine.
How do you feel about no-fault insurance being eliminated? It's a certain part of no-fault. It's called a personal injury protection, PIP, where your own insurance company pays your losses, medical, death, and certain expenses. How do you feel?
We need that.
Should keep that.
We should keep that.
But that would drove the price of insurance up high.
But we should keep that because I had a gentleman run into me. He was from Mexico, didn't have any insurance, and so I had to end up fixing my vehicle.
So then you do no change to car insurance, leave it as it is?
I would leave it as it is.
Okay. Now, how do you feel about taxes overall going up? And where will the increases be, you think, if the taxes are going to be raised? Where?
We get more employment and more companies in here and more jobs. I don't think we're going to need to raise the taxes.
Okay, but sooner or later you have to raise taxes, sooner or later.
Well, not if we have a booming economy.
Okay. What about workers' comp insurance taxes?
Workers' comp, that's needed. Mm-hmm. We need to keep that.
Okay. Now, you've been here now 6 years now in the state?
No, I've been here 12 years.
What made you decide to run for governor and create a whole new party on top of that?
Well, I couldn't get anyone to listen to my point of view, my ideas about being a conservative, and I didn't identify with the Democratic Party, and I was sort of pushed out by the Republicans. I was a member of HREC here, Hillsborough County Executive mm-hmm. Committee, and I did the thing with the Tea Party. We went and protested in the streets against the Obamacare. Remember that when I was there. I've got pictures. And I was out there every time. And I was there for 3 years. And they put up this montage of pictures. And I look, and there's not one picture of me.
What happened? You were photoshopped out?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. And that's happened to me in Orlando. OCREC. And even the TV stations. I was right there in front when Governor Scott was at the Harley-Davidson for his reelection.
Okay.
And our former Rick Scott was there also. Well, he used to be my governor. And every time Governor Scott sees me, he said, "Flora, come to the front." And I was right there. He was at the podium. I was right behind him. Rick Scott, former Governor Rick Scott, came and kissed me on the cheek. Governor Scott kissed me. And then the next day I look at the news and I'm just a black haze. You can't even see me.
Well, Jimmy, be sure and Photoshop her out of the interview, okay?
when they run it, I'm Photoshopped out.
You might as well continue the tradition.
Continue the tradition. So I'm thinking, okay, I'm being pushed out. God is pushing me into something.
Well, why would they do that?
Because they didn't want anyone to know that Governor Scott had African-American supporters. And he had, it wasn't just me, there were others there.
Okay.
And that's from the liberal view. They're always trying to block out, and not only the liberals, but some establishment conservatives. They don't want us, they have a fear of us taking over the power.
Where is this party going to be located at, the headquarters of this party?
It's downtown Orlando.
You have an office set up already?
121 South Orange Avenue, Suite 1500.
That's just south of I-4?
Yes.
Do you have a staff there, telephone, bank?
Yes.
When did the office get started?
I've had the office for about 2 years.
Really?
Yes.
How come I never heard of it?
Because I'm just slowly building up. It takes a long time to start a party.
Who pays the overhead there?
Me, myself, I, and God.
I mean, out of your pocket?
I'm sorry? Out of my pocket, personally, okay. Yes. Because if I don't invest in myself, who is going to invest in me?
How big is your staff?
Right now, it's a small staff. It's about 7 people, but we're... Like I said, I have a volunteers list of people that have called and said, we're willing to come in and help you.
Do you work full-time, these 7 people? Your staff, do they work full-time?
Part-time.
Okay, wow.
Yes.
Incredible.
Yes.
So you just jumped out there.
Yes, it hasn't been overnight. It's, like I said, 2 to 3 years I've been working on this.
Now, one thing about Florida, it's a state with a lot of different ethnic background in Florida.
And I love that.
Luckily, we've not had any problems with that.
Right.
But with influx of Puerto Ricans and the limited resources of the Atlanta area, you may see problems now. The Puerto Ricans are going to be competing for jobs that African Americans get. because a lot of Puerto Ricans don't get along well with Hondurans and El Salvadorians and Cubans and everybody else. How do you plan on keeping the lid on this getting to be a bigger problem?
Well, we have our law enforcement, and they must follow the rules like everyone else. And if we have a problem, like you say, the shortage on jobs, I'm an entrepreneur, like I said, a commercial real estate broker. And so I am good at talking to companies, bringing companies in, so we can have more of an employment opportunity. But as I stated before, 5 years is enough.
What are you going to offer? You have four different segments in the state. You have the black, mm-hmm. white, you have the Hispanics, and then you have the LGBT group. What are you going to offer those different groups?
I'm going to offer them the same that I would offer any group, the opportunity to educate themselves, the opportunity to have a job, the opportunity to have a safe living environment,
okay,
and the opportunity to promote their religion.
So you ain't doing nothing special for any particular group?
No, I do not believe in special groups getting special. You're a human being. You're humankind, okay, and I treat everyone the same as God would.
How do you plan on expanding the economy with more jobs and more industry and more construction?
More jobs, more industry, more construction, more education,
so how,
more
what,
invention.
What things would you do to?
I would promote small businesses, getting startups.
Okay.
Yeah, startups for small businesses. I believe strongly in entrepreneurship. That's what I've done all my life. In other words, the salesperson. And when you do that and you have your own business, no one can put a ceiling on what you can make. And that's how I decided to become my own entrepreneur, because they were trying to cap what I can make.
Okay. Very interesting. Our time has wound down. We need to have you on again.
Okay.
And maybe next time have a 1 hour show.
Thank
you. I've been talking to F.D. Moore, running for governor, and your party name is called what?
New Centurions Party. You can find us at newcenturionsparty.com.
Running for governor. So y'all go out and vote for her, okay? Al McCray signing off. TampaNewsAndTalk.com.
Thank you, Mr. McCray.
Tampa Last Place News.
Thank you for having me.
It's a pleasure. Our show is on the internet also, so if you missed this show or the last show, we're on the internet at TampaNewsAndTalk.com, click Talk Shows, and we're on the cable every Saturday at 2 p.m. And thanks again for watching TampaNewsAndTalk.com. Don't forget, we're Tampa's Last Place News.